Today we're going to take a look at the Terminator from Teslacig with the Antman 22 RDA. This is a budget RDA kit. I bought this for the purpose of review from eBay. It was a grand total of £12, so it's a very cheap mod. So it comes in a lovely orange circular box, which is a bit of an odd one. At the top you get a section that's got your mod in it, and at the bottom section you get your RDA and all your user guides. You do get two user guides. You get one for the Terminator there and one for the Antman. And these are in multiple languages, all your basic stuff. It looks like they're translated ones because some of the English is pretty bad. Not going to do an unboxing, but we are going to do a breakdown and a build on the RDA. So let's jump down, do that, and we'll come back, have a vape, and talk about the pros and cons on this device. So here is the Teslacig Terminator with the Antman 22 on top. It does look okay, actually. It does look pretty decent. But let's take off the Antman and we'll take a look at the mod first of all. So here is the mod. You see it's got a bit of scratching where the RDA has been sitting. And there's the 510. It's not spring-loaded. It's not adjustable. The fire button is nice and clicky, so it does have that. And at the bottom here, more scratching where the paintwork is working away. On this side, you get the Teslacig logo and the LED indicator. And you see some nice venting on the battery door there. Same venting on the other side. And here's the USB port. Also, see some more scratching going on. On the back there, we've got the battery door, and it does say Terminator on it. Now, the battery door is held in place by magnets. We pop the door open, and you'll see that the magnets are no longer in the door. This is a problem that I've started having. So you spot in there, it does actually have a positive and a negative indicator. But you see, there's the magnet. It has come off the door and it's popped it back in. So I'm going to pop this back in. So I've popped the magnet back in the door. So we'll just pop the door back on. There you go. You can see it installed there. And, I've put it in upside down. So now it won't close at all. So I'll have to take that back and try again. So now I've got the magnet in the right way around. We just pop this on, it will just pop into place. There we go. And we'll take a look at the Antman RDA. So here it is, 22mm RDA. Bottom and top airflow. Says Antman on one side and Teslacig on the other. At the bottom, no sort of markings at all. You've got a screw for adjusting the positive terminal. So if we take a look, the drip tip does come off. Now, it's neither 510 or 810 compatible. It looks closer to the 810, but is proprietary, so pretty much that's it. You've got your spit guard in there, which is a nice little feature. Then your top cap comes off. You got your adjustable airflow in there. And then inside, you've got the airflow section, so that comes off. And you see the top airflow there. It's all through. And if you actually take a look with the airflow section in place, you'll note that the airflow is actually above where the posts are. So it's above the top of the posts. So unless you're going to be putting your coils in a strange way, it's going to be coming in above the coils. And there we go, velocity style deck, pretty standard deck section there. And you've got your bottom airflow. It looks quite big on the deck section, but if you look at the actual holes where the air is coming in, it is quite small. So let's put a build on this. So here we go, got a build on here. It's a 26 gauge canthol in 6 wraps, coming in at 0.26 on the ohmmeter there. And as you can see, I'm not finished adjusting this build. It's not perfect in any way, shape or form, but you can see from the airflow you need to position the coils so that you're getting that bottom airflow coming through. But then when you put your top cap airflow on, you'll see that the airflow is coming in above the coils, so it's just going to come straight in and not really do anything. So unless you shift your coils all the way up, that's not really going to do much. So we'll get it wicked up and I'll show you the wick once it's wicked. So here we go, all wicked up. So the key point to note here is that when you are wicking, you want to make sure there's a gap for the airflow to come through. So underneath where the coil sits, you want to have the gap underneath the airflow, so then your air can come up under the coil and bring that flavor up. So you want to make sure the wicks are avoiding. So we'll just juice this one up. I know it's not the most pretty build that I'm doing here, but it is a quick build that I'm doing on this one just to show how it all sets. So we'll get it juiced up and fired up, and there we go, we're getting a nice little burst off that. So get it juiced up and I'll get it put together, and we'll come back up top and talk about it. So there we go, and let's have a vape on the bad boy. You see it's got a nice bit of cloud production going on. The flavor's coming through pretty good. It's a 0.26 ohm build that you've seen there. Bit of confession, that was actually the first build that I put in this. This is a second build I've had to do. First time I did it, there was an issue with the camera. Part of that video did not complete, so I've had to reshoot it, and it's the second build that I've actually got in here. So it is the same build that I did, it's just one that I did off camera. And the flavor that I'm getting off that is pretty good. And the collab production is there. I have a fully charged 18650 in here to get that production. Of course, this is a dripper, so need to do a bit of dripping as we go. So we're gonna have a look at the pros and cons on these devices. So on this device, so we're gonna split it up a little bit. Do the pros and cons for the mod, and then we'll do the pros and cons for the RDA, and then we'll do an overall sort of mark on the whole thing because it is a kit. So for the mod, there are a lot of cons, unfortunately. So first off, you will have noticed all the paintwork that's chipped. I've only had this device about 2.5 weeks, and all that damage has happened in that time. So all the chips that are away on the paint, especially around where the 510 is, and especially around the edges, that's all happened in the last 2 weeks. The problem with the battery door, so this only happened to yesterday. I took the battery off the door off to change the battery. I'd used the power, all the power in one 18650, I was changing to another, and the magnets came off the door. Luckily, it hasn't happened there. Another problem with this is that you'll see very, very sharp edges there, and I've actually managed to scratch the wrap off one of my 18650s from putting it in this device. So it's got a rip in the wrap there because of it. So that's another con there. Obviously the magnets, when they've come off the battery cover, I've lost one of them, so I've only got one now, so it's not tight, it's not sealed, the bottom there is now loose, and you've seen the problem in the download where I put it in backwards and it wouldn't close at all. So almost every time I'm taking the battery door off now, that magnet's just popping out, so that really, that should be glued in there, so, or something to hold it in place. Another problem that I had with this as well has been the USB port. So I went, once again yesterday, I had this out and about. I was on my second 18650. I didn't have a third with me, and I was running out of power. So luckily I was at work. I went to plug it into USB, and I couldn't get the USB cable to go in because the actual USB port underneath the slot there had moved. So I couldn't actually get it in, so I had to do a bit of adjustment to get that in. Took me about half an hour to get it in place, and once I did, I had to hold the cable in place to actually get it to connect and charge and jerry-rig it, and that wasn't ideal. The biggest problem I've had with this, though, has been the 510 connector. So the 510 connector, it stopped working completely. I put my first build in it with the coils that came with it, and it was when I went to put a second build in, went to tighten it off, and it wouldn't fire. And I was getting a short circuit warning from it. It does say in the user guide how many flashes mean a short circuit. I did multiple tries. I did try different RDAs on it, and I was getting a short circuit constantly, even when I didn't have an RDA attached. So I took it apart and I took a look, and I discovered that within the 510 connector, there's a little rubber grommet that separates the center positive terminal from the negative terminal, and that had been installed upside down. And because it had been installed upside down, it slipped down the cable, and therefore there was a short circuit being generated. Luckily, this has short circuit protection. Otherwise, that would have been a battery venting issue because that can happen from a short circuit. So luckily, it has a bit of protection in there, but it's not ideal for that. So got that fixed up. The next problem is
You notice there's a bit of wobble on the RDA. Now that's not the RDA that's got the wobble. The wobble is the 510 pin. Now within this, I only know this because I've taken it apart. I've discovered what the problem is. The 510 sits in a floating sort of deck section. It's not connected to, it's not spring loaded, it's not adjustable, it's just sitting there floating. And that floating is meant to sit in a metal plate. That metal plate sits on a plastic bit of the build. And within there is a plastic upright section cut out on the metal section that's meant to slot in, except they don't fit. The plastic section is too big. There's no way to fit it on, so therefore the entire 510 connector is loose. It just wobbles. And it doesn't matter what RDA you put on here, what tank you put on here, it's going to wobble because it's not tight, it's not fitting. So that's all the issues that I've had with this little device. There are some pros. Obviously short circuit protection is good. You've got a five click on and off. You've got the LED for indicating battery life, so that's quite good. Short circuit protection obviously in there. It's got overcharge protection, it's got short voltage protection, it's got all those good little protections in there, which seem to work, which is quite good. It looks, before it got all scratched up, it did look really good. I've seen it in stainless steel, I've seen it in black. It'd probably be a lot better in stainless steel because then it wouldn't get scratched up, at least not to the same degree. It does feel quite good in the hand. Another con I did miss there, it heats up a lot, especially if you're chain vaping on it. You do feel a lot of heat, and it's not heat coming from batteries, heat's coming from here. So it's a lot, it does heat up a lot as well. So that's another con there. So there's a lot of cons on it. Pros wise, there's not a massive amount of pros. I do like the clickiness of the button. I do like the shape, the look of it. I do like the feel of it. I do like the price of it. But price is overall, so we'll come to that when we're doing the overall bit. Now we're going to have a look at the RDA. So the RDA, the Antman 22mm, so it's a 22mm RDA. You've got your velocity style deck, which is really nice and easy to build on. Obviously with the bottom airflow, that does help bring the flavor through and everything. Now the top airflow is effectively useless. It doesn't really do anything because it is so high. It's just there as an aesthetic. You can close it down, you can open it up. It really doesn't make much difference. I tend to have it closed just because it's not doing anything. And the flavor production is there because of that bottom airflow. It's bringing it up and it is generating quite good. And the flavor is very flavorsome. So for a flavor and cloud production scale, it's actually not a bad little RDA. You can't change drip tips. That can be a downside to some people. It doesn't bother me. It does look quite fine with that. The spit guard protection in there, that's actually quite a nice thing. It does stop getting massive spit back off it, which is something that you want from a 22mm. Now, problems that I've got with it, when you want to drip on it, you can either take off the entire top cap, because of that spit guard, you can't really drip straight down the drip tip, which is a bit of a pain. So you can either take off the entire top cap, which is really loose, I gotta say. It doesn't sit flush. You can see there's a bit of a gap there. And it's not tight at all. I do find it easier to take off the top airflow and drip onto it that way. That's just because it gives a bit of space, it protects a bit from the from getting any leakage at all. When you are dripping on this, because of the bottom airflow, you don't want to drip directly onto the coils, because that will just go straight down and out the airflow and you'll get some leakage. You want to be dripping more onto the wicks, sort of wick up. It's not a very deep juice well, so there's not a lot of juice. You do find that you are dripping quite a bit with this one. But the flavor's there, the production's there, so it's not that bad an RDA. And I have used it on other devices just to get an impartial view on it. I didn't want, because of all the issues I had with the mod, I didn't want my view of the RDA to be swayed by that. And as a little dripper, it's pretty good. It does the job it's meant to do. It's a nice, easy build on there with the velocity style deck. The top airflow is pointless. It doesn't do anything. It can, I mean, it does sort of cool the vape down a bit. It does add a bit more air to it, but it's not doing anything to the flavor. If anything, it's washing the flavor out, because it's not, the airflow is not going anywhere near the coils. It's just coming in and up. So a bit of a bad design there. Really, they should have put the airflow where they had the, where they've got the logos here. So instead of having the airflow then logo, it should have been logo then airflow, or flip them over, and then it would have worked a lot better. There's no adjustment on the bottom airflow either, so that is a bit of a con there with that. You can't make it larger, make it smaller, turn it off completely and use just the top. Because if you could do that, then it would be effective top airflow, because there was then there'd be nowhere else for it to go. But there's not, it's not at all. So it is a bit of a hit and miss on that. It's not the best RDA out there, but it's not that bad. It's not that bad. So that's both devices. So we'll do an overall on it next. So overall, we'll have to take in the main pros here. So the main pro is the cost. This was £12 on eBay. It is the cheapest RDA kit out there. So that's a pro, but it's also a con. Why do I say it's a con? Well, it's £12 and this is not a beginner's kit in any way, shape or form. The number of problems that I've had with this kit, if you don't know what you're doing, this is dangerous. The battery door, the 510 connector, the USB charger port, they're all issues. It's really poorly constructed, it's really poorly put together, and with a wobbly 510, I mean, after this review, I don't think I'm going to be using this again. I do like the look of it, I do like the feel of it, I do like the size of it, but it's got so many issues with it, it is, in my mind, dangerous. So it's not there for anyone who's not experienced with vaping. This is definitely not a beginner's device. The RDA is good, and for the price, it's a pretty good price for an RDA. £12 for an RDA is not bad at all. So that's really what we come away with here, is it's a cheap RDA and you get a kit that's not very good with it. And that's pretty much where we end up. Would I recommend? No. Wouldn't recommend this to anyone. There are better RDAs out there for the price. Even though you get a kit with it, there are better 22mm RDAs out there. Plenty of them. Even if you go down the clone route, there's loads of options there. And to be honest, it's not convenient for dripping. The flavor's okay, but the flavor's okay off any RDA. That's down to your build. So I'm afraid this is definitely a thumbs down. It's not a recommend. The number of issues that I had with this, no. Wouldn't recommend it to anyone. So, sorry, Teslacig. Go back to the drawing board on this one. And it's been out for a while. It is cheap. If you fancy a challenge, go get one. If you fancy something that's going to keep you scratching your head, trying to keep it running, then go get one. If you're into rebuilding a mod, go get one. But otherwise, steer clear. Wouldn't touch it with a barge pole. So that's it for the review. Feel free to go check out some of my other videos on the channel. I do vape reviews, I do previews, I do upcoming mods, I do vape tips, vape news, loads of vape related content, and a vlog. So go check that out on the channel. The subscribe button's been up the whole way through this video, so hit that. Feel free to hit that like button as well if you like this video. And feel free to jump on over and follow me on Twitter. It's at OnePurpleMongoose. I do also have a Patreon as well. It's www.patreon.com/purplemongoose. Jump on over to there. There's a reward scheme in place. There's a video over there explaining it. I do giveaways on the Patreon, but don't expect this one to be in it unless I don't like you. So this one's not going to be in there. That's it for the minute. And as ever, Keep on.